This is an opportunity for us to have open dialogue.
My name is Darwin Figueroa. I am a founder of Fresher Fresh, a media content company.
Hi everybody, I'm Brayna Noriega, visual artist and a writer. I identify as Black Hispanic, if that's a choice. Usually it's not, it's usually one or the other.
Hi, I'm Ashley Solage. I'm an event producer. I identify as Black and Hispanic as well.
Hi everyone, I'm Chris, owner of R&B Collective, an event producer. I guess I contribute myself as Black and Hispanic as well. Yeah, let's go with that.
I still struggle with it to this day. It's not something that's been set in stone in my head. Because of the fact that there's really no, I'm gonna explain it. There's really no Black or Hispanic or any of those categories that would like, that I feel comfortable in.
My mother is Panamanian. I grew up in a Panamanian household in Virginia. So we didn't really have a culture outside of my household. It was kind of just like Spanish was spoken to a minimum, but it was like only inside of my house.
People are not going to identify to something that is seen as sinister and it separates them from the goal. In Brazil, they have the term, you know, money whitens, poverty darkens. So therefore, all of these different classifications of Blackness, as well as going back to the Costa system, where they're talking about the Dias de Sangre, as well, all of that has played a part in why people don't choose to identify as Black. So it's known, yes, we are Black, but we don't have to admit to it if it means that we're going to be looked down upon or other.
But I have a question, though. Is there an international Blackness?
Blackness is global. Okay. You know that anything that has Afro in front of it, you're Black. It's referring to Africa. All Blackness comes from Africa, and the diaspora is huge. Yes. Blackness is global. And so I understand why you might not feel comfortable with it, and I wish you much peace on your journey.
Because I'm Cuban Haitian, and my Cuban family called me Negra my whole life. My nickname for my family is Negra. My Haitian family hated that nickname. Why would they not call you? You can't come up with a better name than Negra. And it's like a term of endearment. But I guess because of the two like contrasting like, cultures, I really identified with said their roots. Like I thought I was much darker.
Very dark skin, saying I'm not Black.
They're telling me that?
Yeah, okay. Because they reference Black as African American.
Yes, right.
Not yes. Black as a black skin. That's what I mean by what
that's
is Black.
You know,
that's the same conversation. That's what I'm asking. What is Black?
Like us, because I have bigger eyes, they have those slant eyes. They were like, you look very mixed. They were like, we can tell that, you know, you've been in America for a while. And I was like, what do you mean? Like, I'm African.
My mother came here to this country when she was in her teens, so she knew a minimal Spanish, minimal English, but not so much. She learned in New York, you know, gathered around, but it's kind of just like she was teased and put to a point where it's just like she didn't want to celebrate her culture and didn't want to celebrate herself being Panamanian because it's kind of just put her in a box in the high school that she went to. So she decided to, you know, just kind of generally erase it. Wasn't passed down to me. I learned Spanish in school, so like dictionary Spanish, like how to conjugate verbs, but I didn't really learn like conversational Spanish or anything like that.
Since I was raised with my Haitian mom and didn't experience the Hispanic side, I didn't experience the suppressing of the Hispanicness, but I did experience like systemic like brainwashing of a Black woman, like not being happy with her hair or like her skin color, thinking she was ugly, all these things. So like growing up, I used to iron my hair every single day for like 2 hours because I just was never told that it was okay to wear my hair like this. So I didn't even know that my hair looked like this until I was like 23.
Cubans are the best example of why we need to have pride in our blackness. Cubans have learned what whiteness does for them. They have taken like the lesson right out of the colonialism book. If you assimilate, you're safe. And if you can be as white as you can, you'll be good. You can acquire money, this and that. That's why a lot of people don't understand why Cubans vote the way they do, how immigrants can be against immigration, because they separate themselves from that. We're here, we're legal. How dare they try to come over here?
The Cuban community is problematic for many reasons. Historically speaking, white Cubans were actually given an open door into the United States, settled with social privileges that African Americans that were already settled here were overlooked and were not receiving. The wet foot, dry foot policy was just ended in the Obama's era, right? The last year of his term. During the era of Clinton's and leading even into Obama, we saw other Caribbean people, like Haitian people, literally being turned away while they're in shanty boats trying to arrive, yet Cubans were given privilege, mostly white-skinned Cubans, right? So I think it's problematic as fuck. On top of that, economically speaking, white Cubans have a monopoly and continue to disenfranchise other people, other Latinos, and especially blackness. So I think, I feel, and I stand by the fact that white Cubans in particular have a very unique position in this country, in Miami, in this city, that's problematic, and I do not see it being resolved unless we see this large influx that we're seeing of gentrification and actually white people coming in and contesting their whiteness.
Mm-hmm. It wasn't until recently that I realized that there's a lot of people who are like me. You know, there's a lot of Afro-Latinos, and it makes me feel good. You know, it makes me feel like I've come into this big community of people that I didn't know existed, but are like kind of like my brethren in some way, shape, or form, you know, because like we all share the same experiences, more or less, and it's something that I feel now it's gonna be addressed in the media. Especially Miami being the epicenter of Latin culture, and a lot of Afro-Latinos in Miami starting to step up to the plate and do things, function such as this.
I agree, and I think that a way for us to help bring representation is people like us supporting other Afro-Latinos in our community, because I've realized that no one's gonna do anything for you, and so it's people like us who have resources or have connections or whatever that can like help people around us, whether it's like booking an artist that's Afro-Latina or like booking a DJ or like helping someone find a job, or even political figures just like campaigning for them, just doing things to help people understand that there are other people like us that are doing cool things around. I just think supporting each other and helping each other with resources is a good way to do that.